Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches Director's Cut Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This is what we have to deal with. We can use the stethoscope here. It's coming from the fireplace. So maybe it's from somewhere further down. Did he add a note on this? I can't investigate the sounds anymore. I can't proceed in the basement without some light. Alright. Let's try leaving the room, which we've already done, I know, but do we? Now what's interesting is that in our dream, which was it really a dream? We heard hammering. There was a hammer here. Behind this was a door. Can't move that. The bottom of the case seemed to have some kind of panel. It was firmly stuck in place. Well, let's mess with it, shall we? Wasn't useful. Can you hurt yourself? Oh! Look at that. We put it back on and we took it off. Okay. What's that? The panel had been concealing a couple of wheels. So, we can pull this thing back and then see what was behind the door. Can we? I don't want to look at these things. Oh. It just automatically goes back on. Well, okay, wheels, but I don't know how to move this. And we just have these small items. Maybe the wheels also need to be, like, oiled or something? Well, that's interesting. But I think it's something we do something... I don't know what I'm saying. It's something we mess around with later on. Now my other idea... If I can turn... Let's head back downstairs. There's a fireplace here as well. We cannot hear any scratching here. Why would I only hear it in my fireplace? The noises were definitely spreading through the fireplace, probably via some conduit. I concluded they had to be coming from below. So what are we gonna do about that? Just as they had begun out of nowhere, the scratching noises stopped. We start a fire. The idea was nice, but it wasn't that cold really, and I preferred the few matches I had left. Kindling? No. Gotta get through the... Alright. Well, the scratching stopped. Now I turn around. I was expecting to turn around and see some face right in front of me. Can we go to bed now? Has the noise stopped in our room? Why is it loudest in our room? The scratches had stopped. I thought it was the right moment for me to go back to sleep. This guy must have nerves of steel. There's no way I could go back to sleep after that. I'd be, you know, especially after reading the letters. Oh, it just says the noises grow louder. I don't think it's supposed to be saying that. Huh. I think it's not supposed to be saying that. Alright. Well, let's try going to bed. I went back to bed. Sunday, October 13th. That's actually like 2 days after I'm really playing this. On the second day, a fierce storm had assaulted the land. I could hear the trees creaking, or rather something, I can't read that, to the lashing of the rain, and I quickly abandoned my hopes of having the power fixed. Yeah, my recording indicator blocked those words. No worry, I'll see it when I, I thought that happened. I'll see the words when I watch back the video, because then the recording icons won't be there. Nothing out of the ordinary. Well, a dreary day, huh? The view is not inspiring right now. I laid my fingers upon the typewriter, but it was unusually cold and immediately stopped my desire to write. Oh boy. You just put things off like crazy. No wonder you haven't finished this novel. What's his journal say? Fortune. Oh, no, wait. Start up here. I managed to track the sounds to a fireplace. They're indeed coming from below the house. Perhaps some machinery? No. Impossible. Not without power. Vermin? Just doesn't sound like it. The undead. Fortunately, the sounds have stopped. At last I can sleep again. But still I should look into this. Probably nothing to worry about, but you never know. Right. I woke today to a fierce thunderstorm. The rain is heavy and I could hardly make out the garden. I don't recall ever seeing something like this. It looks like I'll be stranded inside the house for the whole day. Also, I had an interesting dream yesterday. Something was luring me to a hidden door in the gallery. I should look into this, just in case it's meaningful. I sat down at my desk, hands on the typewriter, but nothing came to me. It's just that there is so much to see here. No, your fingers were cold. Be honest. Fingers are cold. Should I go check the case again? Let's check the case again. I couldn't move it. I want to pull it back and see what... Whoops. I want to pull that back. Couple wheels, yeah. But I can't do anything. Do I need a lever or something to pull it from the wall? Try this now that I'm here. Not useful. Oh, that's the key to the basement, I remember now. Wow. Really coming down out there. So, there is apparently... See, here I can't turn to see the crack or anything. Was that here before? Oh yeah, that was here. Yeah. I didn't realize what the edge of the paper was. Alright. I don't think there's anything more we can do in here. Perhaps it would have been valid to open that not in the middle of the night, but to open it at this point. Should we call Jerry? Watch, we take out the power telephone lines. Ah, it's ringing. Let me guess, the electrician's not going to come in this weather.
Hello?
Michael, how are you doing over there? The sky's falling here.
Same.
You mean this storm has hit there, too? Seems the entire universe is falling here. I'm afraid to go outside.
Well, the better then, as I won't be able to come for you. I'm deeply sorry, but it's seemingly impossible driving to Northumberland. Even less getting anywhere near the manor. I understand many of the roads are closed.
So much for my hopes of seeing Mr. Electrician today, then.
Yep.
Ah, the benefits of being away from society, eh? I should have listened to you.
Don't panic. I'll come right for you, as soon as this thing is over. You just hang on in there.
It's not like I have any other choice, do I?
I'm afraid not, my friend. This storm has the power to disturb the dead.
Well, it seems like this very same storm has awakened the evil spirits resting inside my new home. Not sure, but I happened to hear some odd sounds last night. Kind of scratching noises down in the basement.
I do remember the cleaning lady saying something about rats.
Unless we're talking about mutant rats here, I don't think that's the problem.
Michael, my friend, you were tired from a long trip and stressed about the problems you found there. On top of that, you had moved to a very old house. Guess what's the most common complaint from people moving to old houses?
Noises.
Ghosts on the loose.
Sort of. Now go focus on your book while you still have enough light. I'll be there as soon as possible. By the way, Michael, I have the combination for the safe right here.
Oh, sweet.
Ooh, great. Tell me.
03211. Just remember to share it if you bump into any expensive jewelry.
Of course I will.
Hear that noise? Sometimes when he talks, you hear a noise. I wrote that down in case we need to actually manually remember that, but he'll probably just open it automatically. Okay, this will be awfully soon, but just in case Barbara's got our Italian letter. It wouldn't have been very polite to bother Barbara on a Sunday. No. Well, then hopefully tomorrow she'll have gotten it. Well, let's head for the safe, then. I'm glad he found that combination. It's almost as creepy as nighttime. Wait. Where am I going? It's down there. In the bedroom. So creepy. he doing it? We got a key. And this. Key. Okay, Mr. James T. Blackwood. The Blackwood Manor. Rathbury, Northumberland. Okay, general contractors. November 11th, 1960. Dear sir, we hereby propose to furnish all equipment, materials, and labor to complete the contract for the construction of a second floor for the Blackwood Manor of Rathbury, Northumberland, in accordance with plans and specifications prepared by Mr. James T. Blackwood, dated October 31st, Halloween, 1960, for the sums as follows. Base bid, £34,136. Alternate number one, deduct £1,000. Alternate number two, deduct £1,500. Alternate number three, add £350. Alternate number four, add £300. I don't know what these alternates are. I guess how much he wants to change it? How much plans for the construction of a second floor, right? Well, the second floor they did. It's the third floor that isn't finished. Unit price number one, £1 per cubic yard. Unit price number two, £12.50 per cubic yard. We agree to commence the work as directed and complete all work thereafter within a reasonable length of time based on our ability to secure materials. Employer understands the construction may last from 18 to 24 months. Permission is granted to make use of the special bank account 6319102, created for this particular occasion, sorry, located at the National Bank of Northumberland, contract number. Alright. What if we call the bank? Well, it's a Sunday. The bank is not going to be open. Still, I want to go down there and see if it's possible to dial that number. 01912-94144. And, just in case I need the account number. Probably don't. I want to automatically do it. Account number 6319102. Right? Where is it? 9102. There's some more stuff in there. Isn't that money? I guess we don't care about that. I want the money, honey. Well, we've got a key. What does the key go to? It was a generic looking key, blue in color. Now, there are a few things outside that require keys. One's bound with wire, but that's the crypt. But the chapel needs a key. And I think there's a garage also that needs a key. I'm trying to think if there's anything locked that we found in the house. Oh! The room upstairs. It's worth a try. I have a feeling he's not going to want to go outside in the rain. Let's see if he says anything new. Like I thought, neither Jerry nor the electrician will be able to come today. This new turn in my life is getting more and more complicated by the minute. I will survive, but deep inside I'm becoming truly concerned. I have opened the safe. I certainly wasn't expecting a treasure, but the contents were far from spectacular. Just a contract for the construction of the house and a key. Well, that is nearby, isn't it? I mean, unless if you're thinking of this is the first floor, and down there is the main level. And this is main level 1-2. Isn't that the way they do things in the UK? think they count floors different than us. Than in the, you know, the US, anyway. I don't know about elsewhere. This one is stuck, I think, right? It's just... He didn't fit there, so we'll try over here. It's funny you think someone was locked in here because the key was put there from the inside. Let's see if it fits here. Did that work? Oh! So, what happened to the person who was in here? Huh. So there's nothing to look at here. We have to advance to look at anything, right? Oh, there's some stuff here. This unfinished room seemed to be used as a storeroom for some sinister paintings. Oh, he's wearing a very nice suit, though. Look at that one. Let's advance. What is that? I thought I saw someone pass by the window. That might just be my imagination. Those graphics were created by my mind this time. Oh! Blueprints. Which floor is this? Is this the main? This is the stairs? The study? I think so. This is the stairs, the study, library, dining room, the little area where we talk on the phone. Here's the stairs up and down. The kitchen. Basement would be here, but it's another floor. The maid's room, I'm guessing that is, and the maid's bathroom. The smallest of the hallways. Oh, it tells you. The entrance to the house, obviously. The living room. The hall where that handy telephone was. Right, it's telling me everything I just already said. Dining room. That was a study with the gorgeous collection of books. The smallest of the hallways. The kitchen, evidently. The staircase leading to the basement. The sad room once occupied by the servant. The servant's bathroom, of course. Okay. The entrance to the house. My lovely room. So, there's a hidden room here. It was that strange African gallery. The long lower hallway. So the hidden room must be here? Is that flush with the door? No, I think it's back more. So it can't be that long. Maybe it's a hidden stairs back there. The main bedroom? The bathroom on the second floor. The last hallway left unfinished and full of garbage. The next one showed the top floor of the house. Common sense dictated it was the very same I was standing in now. Right. All the rooms on this floor seem to be in very poor condition. The last hallway left un- yeah. Thank you. Because I don't need that pencil. I already have a pencil. It was a schematic blueprint of the ground floor of the house. Several cans of paint were scattered throughout the room, probably all dried up by now. Apparently nothing else to see on this table. Whoever painted these pictures must have been deeply disturbed. I'm feeling disturbed just looking at them. Easel? Is that what it's called? Disturbed, I tell you. Disturbed. Well, we got a hammer. Is that what that is? Yeah. There was nothing out of the ordinary about the hammer. Well, we can do something with it, I'm sure. So we're here. The only place we can walk to is back. This way. Can I open this now? Yeah. Oh! Another room! I figured I'd be back out into the hallway. Even more food for termites, or whatever little buggers, inhabited this part of the house. Looks like you can open that. Oh, we're... What are we doing? We got a rope? A large rope is hanging from a railing above. Does somebody want to hang himself there? Can we cut off some of the rope? Aha. Do we take some of it? No. We just cut it. Why do we cut it for? A very dirty can. A useless can of grease. I guess we're going to pick up the rope from down on the floor. Several dusty cans were resting on the platform. One of them, in particular, was dusty, more dusty than the rest. That's for oil. Isn't it? It's a, whatever you call it. It was just an oil can. Oh, it's an actual oil can. I thought it was a funnel. That's the word I was looking for. It was just an ordinary can of paint. I'm gonna put paint on something. I'm just randomly trying things. So now we can add this to this, right? It didn't need to be oiled. Oil the wheels in the African gallery room. Yes. Yes, baby. A useless can of grease. You put grease on anything. Why not? It didn't need to be oil. This is just to oil things, not to add things. All right. The rope. I want it. I can't get that. Do I have to step over here or something to get it? Why did we take that down? I can't pick it up? Huh! Why cut it down if we don't need it? I don't know what I'm doing. It's not even as an... Wait. I don't want to use it. Well, the rope was attached to this pulley? No, it was just wrapped around that. Let's see if I see anyone hanging up there. I guess maybe we'll come back and get the rope another time. I don't know. I don't need it yet, but yet I can cut it. So we can... Can I open this door now? Can I see anything from here before I go? No. There's a window up there. Awfully high place to put a window. Oh! I wanted to try to flick the light. I knew it would be pointless. Just wanted to see if it could say anything. I managed to open the door from the other side. Okay. I always hate when I do something new and the music stops. It's like, how dare you? You've made progress. Now you're in trouble. Let us try to move the little tusk. Well, the not-so-little tusk case. It's the other door. Anything new in here? Nope. Oil the wheels. The door was heavily barred, and its appearance reminded me of something I had read. There was no way I could remove those boards with my bare hands. Is that blood? I actually don't like this. Whatever's in there is not supposed to be removed or let out. And here, I'm gonna let it out, aren't I? The room was too dark to see anything. Oh. Didn't need to be oiled. Alright, so it's not this oil. We need another kind of oil. That's not lamp oil, that's WD-40 or something. I'm trying to light something else. But it won't let me. Well, and we can't see anything else here. Looks like the room goes down, though. I mean, we're standing here, right? And it goes down. Well, that was crazy. As it turns out, there really was a door behind the exhibitor in the gallery. I probably subconsciously noticed the frame yesterday and then dreamt about it. I can't think of any other reasonable explanation. Could have been. Could have been subconsciously. Could have been... You weren't dreaming after all. I don't know. So what else? We have a key. To what, though? Oh, we found out what the key was for. Never mind. I wonder if the key goes to anything else. I bet you it doesn't go outside. The storm is raging outside, and I didn't feel like strolling around the garden. Very selfish of you. What time it is? 11 a.m. So what else can we grease, hammer, unlock? The phone line seemed to be down. I decided to try again later. Oh boy. Can't even call anyone now. Well, I'm going to have to ruminate on what to do next. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.